So it's lovely to be here today and see so many faces. Obviously, I know many of you, and hopefully I'll meet the rest of you during the evening today. So as you've heard, I'm Mark Bradley. I'm director of Proteus. And Proteus is a fairly large research project, which is supported by one of the research councils in the UK, the Engineering and Physical Sciences Research Council. And a key element of Proteus is that it brings together a fantastic group of young PhD students and early career researchers to bring new technologies into life. And these technologies are really focused at trying to help us understand disease, trying to help us diagnose patients, but with a specific focus in the area of the lung, and that's what you'll actually see in the pod today, that our research is really focused on trying to improve healthcare within the environment of the lung. And we want to really bring our technologies to life and can apply them to make patients' lives better. But as well as fantastic research, you know, a real key element of what we do in Proteus is we want to kind of get our passion for research, our enthusiasm for engineering, out into the broader world. We want the general public to really understand what we're working on and why we're actually doing what we're actually doing within the research labs. And that kind of really brings us to why we're here today. You know, we don't want to work in isolation. We don't want to work in a closed box. We want to actually bring it out and show you, and because we're really proud of what we're trying to do and what we're trying to accomplish. And that's why I think this research pod that you'll see today is actually so important. It's actually allowing us to really explain what we're doing and why we're doing it and potential longer term impacts of what we're actually going to achieve. So what I'd like to do is kind of just thank the Glasgow Science Centre for really putting together a fantastic team who have worked with the fantastic PhD students from Proteus and with Helen and so forth. Without all your fantastic efforts and it really tremendous team effort, it wouldn't have been possible to put this fantastic exhibit and research pod together. So I really thank you, and hopefully I can talk to some of you this evening. I'll pass over to
colleagues, distinguished guests, friends, many of you are all of these things. It really is a great pleasure to be here this evening for the opening of the Proteus exhibit at Glasgow Science Centre. So what I hope you're going to see this evening is that the Proteus project can truly be said to be shining a light on the lungs, helping us to diagnose and understand diseases that are of this important and delicate. So we know that over 1,000 people a year in the UK will die of lung disease, and several tens of thousands more will be admitted to intensive care units because their lungs are failing to deliver enough oxygen for their body's needs. The causes of this lung failure can be very varied. They can be infection, full-blown pneumonia, inflammation, leak of fluid into the lungs. But unless we know which of these we're dealing with, it's difficult to give the appropriate treatment as quickly as possible. And that's what the technology that Proteus offers is aiming to achieve. If we can tell whether the shadowing that we see on an X-ray is due to infection, if it's infection, which bug is it, and even what antibiotics will treat that bug rapidly, that helps us deliver the best treatment to the patient as quickly as possible. So the medics, chemists, physicists, engineers who all work in Proteus are aiming to develop new ways to access and image the very furthest parts of our lungs, the alveoli, and then use chemical probes to diagnose the causes of the damage and injury to the lung. Getting an accurate diagnosis promptly could make all the difference to the patient, as I've said. So where does all this research happen? Well, Kev has told me to boast a little bit about Edinburgh, so I will. So the University of Edinburgh is ranked 4th in the UK and 12th in the world for medical science. And Proteus is based within the MRC Centre for Inflammation Research. That's the UK's Medical Research Council, which has funded us for the last 17 years now to deliver internationally leading research on the causes of damage to the lung and the mechanisms that are used to repair it. The advent of Proteus and its spectacular growth over the last few years has breathed new energy into our centre, I think it would be true to say. And I think you can see how the biologists in the MRC Centre can develop new target molecules, that Proteus can develop new probes for to further expand our understanding of diseases of the lung. For us in the MRC Centre, it's very exciting to see our research translated so rapidly into patients, but also the fundamental research that's going on can give new ideas to the Proteus team. So it's this sort of synergistic working between two research councils, the MRC and the EPSRC, between all these different types of scientists that makes Proteus the unique and exciting thing that it is. So since its inception, as Mark has already mentioned, Proteus has really made the effort to communicate the excitement and promise of their research, helped by very energetic and talented students and postdocs, but also by some very pretty pictures, I think, that come out of the Proteus team. So they've exhibited at the Edinburgh International Science Festival, they've exhibited at the Edinburgh International Book Fair. But there's something very special, I think, about having a permanent exhibit that will enthuse people about the work that goes on in their centre. So we hope that visitors to the Glasgow Science Centre will want to learn more about the Proteus and other projects that are going on in science in Scotland, and see how the many different types of scientists are all working together to improve medical care. So I wish everyone a very pleasant evening, and I'm looking forward to getting inside the pot when the ribbon is cut. Thank you.